More app developers are getting into augmented reality on Android now that Tango is a thing of the past. Google's official AR platform of the future is AR Core, which will work on most devices. Even eBay is getting into the AR game with its latest Android app update. Sellers can now use AR to choose the right box size after selling an item. The app now offers the option to superimpose various shipping box sizes onto your item to see how it will fit. eBay notes the AR box picker only works on compatible devices, but it doesn't say which devices those are. Judging by the use of the Pixel 2 XL in the promo image, though, this is most likely an AR Core feature. That means only a few phones will work, including the Pixels V30 and Galaxy S8. But this new app could make shipping those odd-shaped items much easier and cheaper as well. Samsung announced its own take on an emoji recently, and thanks to its partnership with Disney, we should see a few familiar faces, like Mickey Mouse. Samsung just unveiled the Galaxy S9 and Galaxy S9 Plus, two of the most highly anticipated phones of 2018, and along with them, we saw the introduction of AR Emoji, essentially Samsung's take on Apple's AR Emoji feature. AR Emoji lets you create a 3D emoji version of yourself, which mirrors your movements and facial expressions, not unlike Apple's AR Emoji. In a way, however, AR Emoji is a combination of Snapchat's Bitmoji and Apple's AR Emoji because it aims to replicate your facial features and create an adaptive 3D avatar of you. Galaxy S9 users will also have the option to create emoji versions of themselves through more familiar characters, Disney characters to be more specific. Samsung has partnered with Disney to bring a library of all-time favorite Disney characters to its AR emoji feature, although details are scarce at the moment. Judging by the company's presentation from Mickey Mouse, well, it will definitely be one of the available characters, and you would have to imagine Minnie and Goofy and even Pluto. Similar to regular AR emoji, users would simply use the front-facing camera to analyze their facial structures. Samsung's partnership with Disney is big news, not just for consumers, but also for those in the business world. Disney and Apple have had a long-standing relationship, and it's not an unknown fact that Disney's CEO Bob Iger is a member of Apple's board. While it remains to be seen whether Disney's characters will remain exclusive to Samsung devices, their partnership certainly won't hurt Galaxy S9 sales. Attention all Trekkies! It's not an exaggeration to say that many people have been waiting for Duolingo's course in Klingon for years now. Well, it's finally making its debut. Star Trek fans, or really anyone who's interested in taking a course in a constructed language, or Conlang, can access a Klingon language course for free right now via the Duolingo website. It will be made available on iOS and Android apps at a later date as well. The course is under license from CBS Consumer Products. It's not the first Conlang that Duolingo has a course for. The service's 200 million users currently have access to both Esperanto and High Valyrian, that's from the Game of Thrones. In the case of Klingon, though, the course development was led by Felix Malmenbeck, who actually speaks fluent Klingon and has been passionate about the language before he even became a fan of Star Trek. But why would anyone want to learn a fictional language? As the course creator points out, it's another way to express fandom and a love for the franchise, especially for those who are interested in the mechanics of language. Many Star Trek fans become curious about the Klingon language at some point, but learning a language takes time and energy, and of course regular practice, especially when you're just starting out. The course couldn't come at a better time. The Star Trek franchise's newest installment, Discovery, has featured the Klingons and their language quite heavily in its first season. It's provided a renewed interest in the franchise as a whole, and Klingons in particular. And now Duolingo has lowered the barrier for entry to learning the language. I suspect you'll hear more Klingon out in the wild very soon. And finally, happening in this week's What The, a man who taunted deputies on his four-wheeler with a beer in his hand is now in custody. Go figure. One evening recently, deputies attempted a traffic stop on three quads driving on a county-maintained road. Now, two of the four-wheelers were good and actually stopped, while the third fled. A little while later, a white male driving that quad returned to the traffic stop and began taunting the deputies, driving around in circles in the middle of the road and shouting, "Come and get me!" Shortly after additional deputies arrived, the four-wheeler accelerated towards the front of a patrol car and narrowly missed it. The suspect was seen holding a beer can in his left hand and yelled as he went by. He then accelerated rapidly and was gone. I'm sure he thought at the time that he was home free, but contact was later made at a residence where the quad was seen last. Witnesses identified the male as 24-year-old Aaron Keith Clark. Deputies got his address, went to his house, and took him into custody. Clark then said that he did not remember the incident due to being intoxicated, but did say he was sorry. Clark is charged with fleeing and attempting to elude and reckless driving. He was transported and booked into the Walton County Jail. Thanks for watching your weekly tech update. If you have a story you think I should feature on the program, well, shoot me an email, djraymcneil@gmail.com. Find us on Facebook, too, at Your Weekly Tech Update, and check out our podcast on iTunes Podcast. Till next time, I'm Ray McNeil. Good night, world.